Hoy nos hemos desplazado hasta Robeco para hablar sobre un fondo de retorno absoluto, el Robeco Strategic Income. Sus características y sus objetivos han sido tratadas por su gestor, por Dominique de Alto.
The markets right now in fixed income, as well as really all of the markets globally, are currently going through what we would call the second phase of the recent crisis. In the first phase, central banks around the globe were forced to inject liquidity into the marketplace to effectively save the financial system from ruin. To do that, they lowered rates. They injected enormous amounts of liquidity into the markets. In this second phase, which is what we enter into with 2010, those central banks now need to take some of that liquidity back. In addition, they need to digest the enormous amount of new debt that they've taken on their shoulders, which is why we're seeing some movement in some of the sovereign risk premiums. Central banks again succeeded in 2009 and 2008, allowing more market participants to feel more comfortable taking risk. The next step is, how does one take additional risk? So we focus a lot of our time trying to figure out what parts of the economy, what parts of the market are going to best succeed in this early stage of recovery. Ultimately, as recovery becomes more complete, then we begin to move into slightly riskier assets. But right now, it's still a very conservative approach. The market is still very cautious. The market's still very volatile. And so to the extent that we do take risk, we take it in very cautious ways. Greece tends to be a very important topic these days. There are different schools of opinion as to whether the big picture, which is, will Greece potentially default or not. We personally do not think that default is an option. We think that a potential for a bailout by the EU and or the IMF is a possibility. And so things could look, or things can certainly appear worse before they get better. But that said, we don't think that the EMU is going to let Greece go away. It's not in the interest of all the other countries. For the same reason that we don't think that Greece would be forced out, and probably for more reasons than for Greece, because Spain is actually a bigger part of the European Union's economy, no, we don't think that Spain is at risk. I would imagine that there will be a lot of issuance in the corporate bond market. 2009, we saw record issuance by the corporate market. The needs of corporations, particularly in Europe and in the United States, are less than they were last year. And so I would imagine that issuance will be lower, but still quite robust. The objective of the fund is to deliver a cash return, in this case, Ionia, the overnight rate, plus 250 to 300 basis points. So that's 2.5% to 3% above that cash. In 2009, we were able to deliver much more than that, 353 basis points, or 3.5%. In 2009, as markets begin to stabilize and volatility shrinks, that type of outperformance becomes a little bit harder to achieve. What we would expect in this type of a fixed income portfolio is to have stable returns, kind of what we call clipping coupon, or just receiving the income of fixed income. So we do think that we will meet our objectives of 2.5% to 3%, but I don't think that the opportunities to be at 4% still exist. Volatility has, at least up until the last 6 weeks, been constantly declining. Obviously, with the sovereign concerns, in particular with Greece, volatility has spiked up again. But we don't just look at one measure of volatility. We look at volatility in all different types of asset classes. This is an asset allocation fund, so where volatility is not attractive in one place, we can actually look into others. So overall, we think that volatility in general is going to be coming down in 2010. I'm not an equity portfolio manager, but I certainly have an opinion about it. Markets generally are motivated by fear and greed, and right now there's fear in the water. So with With what's going on in Greece in particular and in some of the other peripheral nations like Portugal and Spain, there is an enormous amount of fear. That is largely what's driving the equity markets down. When and if the Greek issue is resolved, the markets will come right back. Well, the euro has been slowly losing value versus the dollar, largely by virtue of the fact that everybody, I think, believes as we do that the European Union is going to have to come in and do something to help Greece. If that happens, obviously, it weakens the value of the euro somewhat because suddenly the euro is not thought to be as strong with as such stiff rules as it once had. That's the problem with moral hazard. If you bail somebody out, suddenly your credibility as a whole goes down somewhat. That said, given other conditions in the marketplace, I would not expect the euro to continue to fall significantly versus the dollar. I think that many absolute return funds of the past had a number of things that we have found ways to learn from. A couple of mistakes. Number one, our fund provides enormous amounts of liquidity that most absolute funds do not because of the types of securities that they buy. And it's not uncommon when markets right themselves for people to forget the types of liquidity needs that a fund needs. And unfortunately, many absolute return funds are going right back to what the types of securities that they once owned, which in times of stress, and over the last 6 weeks we've seen some stress, you lose liquidity immediately. So one of the unique things about this fund is that it can guarantee next day liquidity, which is definitely something that we've learned from the past. Number two, there have been quite a few instances, not necessarily absolute return funds, but certainly plenty of Madoff, Bernie Madoff type moments when our clients have told us we really would like to see more transparency in the fund. We want to know what you're doing. We want to know why. We want to know that you're not operating out of some sort of a black box that we can't see into. And so learning from that information, we have gone to great lengths to build a system that our clients can actually look at, can understand, and can see at any given moment what we're doing, why we're doing it, and why we make the changes that we make.